Welcome, everyone, to Taste Different Gaming Appetizers. And tonight we're going to talk about something that's supposed to be coming out very soon, but has problems. We're talking about Forza Motorsports. It's going to be missing some legacy features at launch. Which, you know, we don't know why. They're just saying technical difficulties. But basically, this game is supposed to come out in October. And bad news. If you like split screen, it ain't going to be there. If you like racing with AI and multiplayer, it also won't be there, and neither will spectator mode. So if you like those features, it will not be coming out at release, but maybe possibly at a later date. We found this out during their recent monthly Twitch stream. The game's official Twitch channel, I guess you will. Creative director Chris Saki spoke out about some of the features that won't be available when the game launches in October. So, you know, those items won't be available. How you feel about that, I do not know, but you'll have to let us know how you feel about those features not being available. I don't know what to think about this. I mean, I have my own opinion about this. I kind of feel that the reason that those items are not there is because of the Series S. That's my opinion. I believe that because of Microsoft's whole parity requirement, you know, whatever comes out on the S has to be on the X. Whatever comes out on the X has to be available on the S. I mean, so maybe they couldn't get those features functioning on the S. We've heard a lot of developers complain about this, but this is a Microsoft studio, so they're not going to tell you that their hardware is to blame for this. But that's my opinion. What does everybody else think is what we're going to kind of get down into. So those three functions are not going to be available at launch. And there's a lot of online talk about comparing this to the Halo Infinite launch, you know, because Halo had cut a bunch of features before its launch. I mean, it cut a lot of features, a good chunk of features too. So they omitted the split screen campaign co-op at launch, and then eventually canceled it, right? Is that because of the Series S? Who knows? Or is it just them deciding that they didn't want to spend money or waste time on the feature? I do not know. I'll be honest with you. I could care less about these features. I don't use them, but that's just me. There are people out there. There's more people out in the world than me, and they might love those features, right? People may want to do AI, AI racing in multiplayer. I don't know why you would want to do that, racing with AI in there, but cool. You might like to do that. I don't know. What do you guys think? Nick, what do you think about these missing features and then the comparison between this and Halo? And what do you think is the root cause of them missing these features at launch?
I mean, again, kind of like you, for me personally, I don't care about the split screen or spectator mode. The driving on the online with the AI might be something I would do, but the other one's probably not. But it does sound like, you know, the Halo all over again. Microsoft seems to have this problem with their first party releases. It seems to be a thing, right? We had it with Halo. Now we have it with Forza. Now I think, could the S be the problem? It definitely could be. We don't know that. And like Pat said, of course, Microsoft's not going to say anything about that, but could it be the problem? It definitely could be. Where these features, and it might be the same thing for Halo Infinite in that case, where it had its problems because of the S. And again, we won't know, and we probably never know if that is the problem, but it seems to be a trend with Microsoft, and where they're having to cut features, and there's got to be a reason for that, right? There's got to be some sort of reason as to why all these games that are coming out from their first party studios have features that are being cut from launch. Not to say that they won't come, they will, but they're being cut from launch, or at least we think they will. You know, split screen, I don't know, right? That may not come at all. And that's what happened with Halo. So, but you know, there's got to be something that is causing that to happen. You know, for Halo, we kind of learned that Halo restarted its development several times. And so that could potentially be the reason why, you know, possibly the reason why Halo had missing features. But for Forza, I don't think they've, had to restart development and things like that. They are going, they say they're going over to a new engine and new graphical technology and things like that and having to do a lot of work there, sure, but that's one thing, yes. But I mean, still though, if you're going to have and promise these features, that the game's going to include these features, they should be there at launch, right? I mean, that's what upset people about Halo and its launch. And regardless if Forza Motorsport is a good game or not, having these missing features is, again, going to hurt it like it did Halo. And if Microsoft keeps going this route with their first-party titles where they keep missing features or excluding features, you know, something's got to give. They either got to say or, you know, do something to rectify this issue. Otherwise, they're just hurting themselves, I feel like. Regardless of what it is, right? We don't know if it's just Playground and they're having some issues, you know, and they're going to not be able to hit the deadline of the release with these features to finish things, other things up before it launches, or if it truly is something else like the Xbox Series S that is holding them back from doing split screen. I mean, besides Halo, Baldur's Gate 3, we just talked about that not too long ago, is going to be delayed on the Xbox because they can't get the split screen working, right? And mainly on the Series S. So again, we're seeing split screen. This is be the third time we're seeing split screen having a problem, some sort of issue. And of course, you know, for the first part, we don't know why, but there is something causing this to happen. And I think the player base, you know, there are going to be players that won't care, like us, you know, or like me and Pat, you know, we don't really, I mean, that's fine if you want to push these things, but others are going to be very upset about this. Doesn't mean they may not play the game or anything like that, but it may hurt potential sales or the way that players look at games, not just this game in particular, but games coming from Microsoft onto a Microsoft platform. This could definitely hurt them, especially if this trend continues, right? We see more and more of this because it started with Halo and then we got Baldur's Gate and now we have Forza. Like, what's the next game that's going to run into this similar issue, right? Microsoft themselves and Xbox really they need to get out in front of this and get it handled before it gets, you know, before it becomes too late. What do you think about it all, Shane?
Without saying, yeah, that's the definitive issue. It really, just doing the math, it seems to work that way, unfortunately. When the S was announced, it was like, that's, you know, that's kind of a neat idea. It's cheap, but it's still got, you know, relatively decent power compared to what was currently out, console wise. The longevity of it didn't last because everything is just I mean, the new Starfield's 136 gigs. It's taken all this power. And it's probably going to look like crap, just like Star Wars looked on the last gen. And because everything's just getting more and more and more, but the Series S can't keep up with all that. It just can't. I'm not a tech guy, so, you know, forgive me, but I don't know why they don't just cut those features from the S. I know it seems, pardon my language, but shitty, but you bought the inferior model. I don't think you can expect the superior game. And I know it sounds shitty because some people can't afford to, you know, buy those. My son still plays on a 1S. I think that's the naming convention. You know, my daughter's played on the 1S, on the original Xbox One. So, I can't afford to buy brand new ones for the entire house, you know, but I'm taken care of, so it's okay. But the, you know, there's just, you know, last gen always, when you had the new generation come out, you always had the last gens that had the same games, but there was features cut from it. Unfortunately, I think they're going to have to do that with the Series S if they want to keep using it. They have to cut features. I mean, if they want to put split screen on the game, they have to cut it from the S if the S can't handle it and just go ahead and put it on the X. you know, Baldur's Gate, you know, it's coming out on PS5 soon. I don't know when it's ever going to hit Xbox Series X. And then it's because of the S. The S was, like I said, it was a novel idea, but I don't think they fully thought it through. You know, like, I'm not a businessman. I'm not a tech man. I'm just a gamer. The S was not fully thought through. I thought it was interesting and cool at first because it was so much cheaper and blah, 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 blah. But now it's like, I can see where it's the Achilles heel of Xbox right now. And they've got to do something with it. And it sucks. I'm not saying they should abandon it. I don't think they can. I mean, I think it's going to just, it'll kill them in the whole, you know, console war. It'll kill them if they were to do that. So they got to figure something out. I mean, even a streaming box isn't going to work for it. So I don't know. They're going to have to get a handle on it though, because the S is it's turning into a lead weight for them, and it's holding them back. You know, their big games, you know, their biggest first party games should not be having these kind of issues. Period. So, you know, Halo, Redfall, you know, Redfall was a whole, just a disaster anyways, but you know, as far as our first party games, this is not looking good on them. And Forza is huge. Forza is a huge game for Microsoft. They can't afford to screw it up. You know, that's just me. What about you, Pat?
I mean, the whole reason, and we know the reason they can't, is because Microsoft basically have made a promise to gamers that games that come out on the X will be the same games that come out on the S. There's no parity. They have to be parity. There's no differences allowed. And that's a constraint that Microsoft has put on developers. If you want to put out a game on the X, it has to be playable on the S with the same features and functions. I think Microsoft needs to abandon that. And what I mean by that is, yes, put the game out on both consoles. We require that you put it out on both. But if it means that you have to cut features on one because, you know, I mean, the whole split screen thing, you know, whatever. If you want to play split screen, we have to stream it or something like that. Make those streaming type decisions. I don't know. Because in my opinion, you can't abandon the S player base. Like Shane said, that's the majority of consoles sold was the S. The S sold way more consoles than the X did. And you will alienate a player base. And plain and simple, the Series S and X have not been out long enough to abandon one of those consoles. You know, Microsoft has to think this through next time. This has to be a lesson learned to them. Because I fully believe that the S, people will argue tooth and nail that the S is not holding the X back. And I'll be like, how? Do you not understand technical difficulties in that broad spectrum of a hardware difference? Do you not understand the concept? I mean, to me, split screen is a perfect example of this being a parity issue. The reason split screen's an issue is because it's a graphical. Think of the graphic intensity it takes to split screen something. You have two people on the same console playing, looking at rendering and having things happen differently on each screen. Like one person seeing what's to the right, one person to the left, or some of these games like Baldur's Gate allow somebody to be completely different area of the map doing something completely different. So they could be fighting some crap over here and you're fighting some crap. You know, they could just be a completely different thing going on. And the console has to render that out perfectly, or at least without hiccups and jitters, right? So obviously, the X can do that way more efficiently than the S can. Plain and simple. If you don't grasp that concept, then you don't get a leg to stand on to say that that one's not holding the other back, because you obviously don't understand hardware concepts and concepts of what a graphics card does versus this or versus CPU versus memory. You don't have those concepts, because I see this a lot where people's like, oh, I don't, the S isn't holding the X back. I don't believe that. And I'm like, then you don't know what you're talking about, because it takes a lot to graphically render a split screen. We're not in the days of GoldenEye, you know, which that was a feat, just four screen split screen that, you know. We're just talking about a very graphic fidelity game with a lot going on and a lot of things happening to be able to portray that on split screen. So Microsoft has to come, and maybe it's on a special request basis, right? You need to come to Microsoft and say, hey, I can't make this work. I want to put my game out on your console, but I can't make this work. And Microsoft has to come to a consensus with you that says you can put this out without parity. It's just got to be known. And maybe that means that at release, it's not there, but you have to put it out within 6 months, you know, and if you don't, there's repercussions, or, you know, or 3 months or something, there's repercussions, because right now there is no known release date for Baldur's Gate 3 on Xbox because of this. And they have explicitly said in a nice way that they can't get split screen to work on the S. They're not saying it's hardware related, but anybody who can put two and two together should be able to tell you that the X can do it, but the S can't. So what's my differentiating factor here? Somebody has to be able to, you have to be able to put one and one together to make two and not one and one together to make three. Because if that's what you're doing and you're saying this isn't, then you might as well just go sit in the corner with your dunce hat on. You leave this conversation. The S is holding the X back. Regardless of what anybody says, there's a hardware deficiency. It's going to cause deficiency. So what do you do in that situation? I have no clue. I'm not a business person. I can't tell you. But me, as somebody who just has an opinion, because everybody has their own opinion, the S has to be able to release games without parity. Or that's a streaming-only game for the S. I don't know. Make it a sale or something. But you can't abandon it, because then you might as well say you killed yourself in the console wars at that point. Microsoft will have basically alienated over half of the current generation's console players that bought the Series S over the X, because the Series S did outsell the X by a good margin. So what do you do?
Yeah. I mean, we talked about this before. I think it was just me and you, Pat, on there, but yeah, you've got to do something. And I think the best route for them, you know, I talked about possibly making it a streaming box where it just streams. I mean, because Switch does this now, right? For certain games, they are just streamed games where you can still play them on the Switch. All you can do is stream them, right? You can't download or put in a game card or whatever into the Switch. You have to just stream it and stream only. They could do something like that with particular games, right? It doesn't have to be all games, but games that do run into issues, technical issues, or just can't compete onto the S, they could become stream only games. Or like Pat said, they allow for like Forza Motorsport. They say, okay, it's coming out on the X and on the S, but on the X, it's going to have split screen. It's going to have the AI racers. It's going to have the spectator mode, but the S version does not have these features, right? Or maybe at launch, they don't have these features. These features will come to it once we get things worked out, you know, and figure out some way to do this. But for launch, it's not going to have it where the X is going to have these features. Because I think ultimately not including or running into this issue, again, like I said at the beginning, is just going to hurt Microsoft as it continues, right? As this continues to come out and we learn more and more about more games running into this, because this wasn't an issue at the start, but it's becoming more of an issue. We're reading more articles and seeing more things from developers where they are running into technical limitations with the S, causing issues with their games, being able to have either, you know, cutting features or not having features at launch, or just not in the case of Baldur's Gate 3, you know, they said they want to release it on Xbox. You know, it's coming out for PS5. They want to have an Xbox version as well. They're not, you know, trying to center out one platform over the other, but they're having an issue and Microsoft is working with them to try to resolve that issue. And that's great. But Microsoft is going to continue having this problem, and they got to their best option. And I know it's going to be bad PR for them, but their best option is to snip it in the bud for now at the start, then to let it fester. Cause it's just going to be worse when they finally have to come in and be like, all right, we got to do something about this.
Right. Yeah. How many games are Xbox gamers going to miss out on because of this parity problem? I mean, right now, Xbox gamers are already missing out on Baldur's Gate 3. Will they get it? Who knows? But all I can tell you right now is that Microsoft just handed Sony a win. I mean, whether they think about it or not, they just handed Sony a win. And it is what it is. It's a bad business practice and they lost out. That's their fault. Nobody else's fault, you know? And now Phil Spencer needs to own that, right?
Yeah. Well, the problem is, you know, in my opinion, is it wasn't a bad idea to try to get your system to as many people as possible by making a lower tiered system. The problem is they didn't, I don't think they put any thought into anything beyond that. Yeah, you should, you know, you want to get your brand out to it. You want to sell as much of that crap as you can. But if you can't even develop for it after a year because it's, you know, limited, it's so limited that, you know, it's pointless to have a million consoles or 10 million consoles when you can't develop crap for it. And Nick's right. I mean, it needs to be, you know, it needs to be a streaming box for, you know, for those games or at least for those features. I didn't even think about for the features of it, but yeah, that's a, you know, good idea. I don't know the technicality of it, but that's, you know, if that's what they got to do, then that's what they need to do. But yes, you're right, Pat, the parity is got to go. It's plain and simple. You know, didn't Microsoft say that the Series X or the S, one of those or both of those, was the mid-gen upgrade?
Yeah, Microsoft said the X was the mid-gen upgrade.
Okay.
When that whole debacle with Sony, or not with Sony, but the whole the Activision Blizzard buyout thing, they said in court that that was their mid-gen, which they just happened to release at the same exact
which
time.
Which means if the S was the actual
you know, console.
Platform, launch console, yeah.
Then they would have been dead in the water from the get go, right? Exactly. I mean, Sony would have blew them out of the water completely, and you might as well just say done and over, right?
Yeah,
and that's what I was getting at is if that's the case, that doesn't make sense because they released, and I know the trying to get the damn naming convention right. The what the hell was the 1X series?
So there's a Series 1, and there's a Series 1, Xbox One, Xbox One S, and then it was the Xbox One X.
The 1S was
the little, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, the 1X was that Project Scorpio, their mid-gen bump.
Yes, okay, sorry. God, I hate their naming conventions. So the 1X, in certain ways, has more power and then the Series S. The S has better hard drive, or no, not hard drive. It has a few features that are, you know, better than the Series X. So that doesn't make sense to me that the Series S would be the generational start. The Series X released at the exact same goddamn time is the mid-gen. Microsoft has one huge problem besides their naming conventions. If this is their, I didn't put it all together until now. Now it's just, it doesn't make sense why they're doing certain things. Yeah. A cheaper console is great, but not at the cost of what they're doing. Cause I mean, God, it's just so stupid. Microsoft makes some of the dumbest goddamn decisions. Pardon my language.
Cheaper console, I mean, like you said, a cheaper console out there makes sense from a consumer standpoint. But they should have done what Sony did. They should have released two versions of the X, one with a disc drive and one without. $100 difference between the two. You know, the S may have helped them somewhat in sales and player base growth, but I think ultimately it's going to hurt them in the end. And it's not like the S would have, you know, they're still in third place. Even if they would have released the X, two different editions of the X, they'd still be in third place. But they wouldn't be running into this issue, right? I get why they did that, but it was stupid. They should have went what Sony did and just released a disc and a discless version and just called it a day, right?
Yeah. Yeah, it really was just another... I think Don Matrick is still working there. He's just in the shadows somewhere, creeping around corners
it's,
going,
it's the ghost.
I know how we can of
Don Matrick.
Ghost of Don Matrick, you know, is screwing this up. You know, it was the right thought, the wrong step to get there. You know, when the new consoles were being talked about, and there was, you know, mock-ups of the Series X, and then there was going to be the discless version, which was just basically a cube. You know, there was all those little mock-ups and stuff going around. They should have went with the freaking cube or the whatever the hell they would have called it then. But, you know, X Mini, whatever the fuck, pardon my language. I get so upset that Microsoft, I love their system. I love the Series X. I love their games. They do the dumbest crap. And this is just, it's hurting them. It's going to kill them. They're going to Dreamcast their way out of this shit if they don't pull their heads out.
I mean, the disparity amongst hardware is just, it's insane. And people don't see it. And there's people, you know, and it's probably, you know, I hate to say this term because I hate when people say Sony ponies, but Xbox or the people who just offend Microsoft because they're Microsoft. I'm sorry, but everybody needs to have a healthy dose of skepticism for all of them because they deserve it. Let's just talk about your GPU, for example. A 52 compute unit CPU versus a 20 compute unit. There's a reason why it can only do 1440 versus 4K on the Series X versus the S. That's just compute units. You're not even half the same parity. You're almost a third. You're over a third, but you're almost a third difference. And then let's talk about your actual power in your teraflops. 12.15 versus 4, a third of the power. I mean, that's just insane amount of difference in those. And that's just in your GPU, which is responsible for all your rendering and your heavy lifting for your GPU. Memory, we're talking about a 10 gig GDDR6, because it's G, versus your 16. That's not a huge difference, but we're also talking about, you know, there's a couple of sub-level memory channels for that are substantially lower, you know. There is a huge discrepancy between these consoles, and people just don't want to admit it, and Microsoft doesn't want to admit it. Microsoft made a mistake by not following what Sony did and what Shane was talking about, just going with the discless version, making $100 off. Microsoft has something that Sony doesn't have, or at least they don't have that I'm aware of, the lease program. If you wanted a Series X and you couldn't afford it, you could have done the lease program, which comes with Game Pass. So, I mean, that's your out right there. We're offering a way to buy a console that Sony doesn't have directly, which is buying it from us on a payment plan. And by the way, the outcome of that payment plan, I don't understand how it works. They have to be losing money, because if you add up the amount of console that you were getting and the amount you paid for Game Pass, you are in the win. You paid less than you would have if you bought it outright and then paid for the monthly subscription and Game Pass over the term of the lease or whatever you want to call it for the console. But I honestly think Microsoft's only way out of that would have been for them to do what Sony did, because then there's no hardware disparity. There's just disc versus there's digital versus disc. And that's all there really was to it. Microsoft should have did that, just like Sony did, because Sony had the better plan out of the gate than Microsoft did. And I'll be honest with you. If Microsoft really is intending that the X is the mid-gen bump and they don't have a Pro or a mid-gen bump, you know, Sony got 4, then to me, that was just them failing at the console wars that shouldn't be going on, but the console wars. They basically played their hand right up front. Sony said, hey, I've got a PS5 disc and discless. That's all I have. And when they announced that, and Microsoft's like, crap, our Series S is garbage compared to that, they panicked. And if this is the case, because this is the only way I can see this happening, and then they panicked and they said, we have an X and an S version, because the X version was probably something they were planning for, like, you know, mid-gen bump for real. I don't necessarily believe that. But then they panicked and they dropped this. And the hardware specification, it's ekes out a little better than the PlayStation on the hardware specs. But not enough for me to even point out. I think Sony's probably a little bit more optimized, and their hard drive's got a little bit, their hard drive has definitely got a little bit better performance than Microsoft's hard drives do. So, but Microsoft's got a pigeon, they're in a pickle. And how do you get out of the pickle?
Don't bite the pickle, I can tell you that.
So, you know, I don't know about you guys, but I think Nick and I beat this thing to death, and unfortunately this Forza Motorsports dredged up the old conversations. But if Microsoft can't make it work and it's their hardware, then that should say something to you, because they can't make parity. Because I would love to be a fly on the wall in here. This works on the S, on the X, but doesn't work on the S. I would love to hear that. And I would love for them to just come out and admit it and just be right in front and honest with everybody and be like, sorry, guys, this works on the X, but we don't have enough compute units or teraflops in our GPU to make this work. Just be honest with your fans. And I think the only way you're going to make this work is that you have to pull a Switch move. Certain games can be played and bought on both, but certain games are only going to work really good on the X, and the S has to stream them. That's the only way I see out of this for them, but that's just my opinion. I'm not a business person, and I don't know how much of a damaging thing that would be to their brand. So, do you guys got anything else you want before, so I can get off my soapbox here?
No, I agree though. I mean, they got to do something, and they need to do something before, like I said, before it gets worse. Cause if we see this trend continuing on, it's just going to be worse and worse for them.
Yep, they need to do an exorcism, get old Don Mattery's ghost out of Microsoft.
Yep, they pull the Warhammer on it and they superimpose Don Mattery's body into the Series S. That was the only way they could exorcise him out of Microsoft. So, you know, we beat this thing into a pulp. It's no longer even twitching. We've hit it so much. So let us know what you think down in the comments. Do you think that this is kind of more proof of S versus X problems, or do you not care? You know, I mean, what is your thoughts on this? Do you care about the features that are missing out of this? You know, so, you know, what are your thoughts on this? Let us know. We'd love to hear about it, you know, and you can help us get through our back catalog of games. If you just make sure you're subscribed to our channel, hit that bell for notification, and make sure you check out every video that we put out. We hope you enjoyed this episode and hope to catch you next one.
See ya.